All right, so if you're watching part two, welcome. Our objectives for caverns: destroy inlet pump controls, destroy outlet pump controls, destroy master control console, minimize scientist casualties. The Yanis Control Center communicates with the GoldenEye weapons system via a large satellite dish, which is usually concealed underwater. The pumps which allow Yanis to flood the communications dish are housed in a subterranean cave complex defended by crack Yanis troops. Don't jeopardize the mission by going for the man bond. Nobody needs a dead hero. You'll be on your own, but CIA combat support will be waiting. Find a radio and inform Jack White of the exact location of the dish, and he'll send in the cavalry. The satellite communications dish is exposed. If you remove the water pumps, Yanis will be unable to hide it again. Destroy the servo control consoles close to the pumps, and be sure to disable the master console. Doing a spot of spelunking. Well, don't mess up your trousers, James. Oh, man. Fortunately, this level's going to be very generous with the ammunition early on. And there's actually a crack in the door right here, where if I line this up properly, I can get that guy through the door. Hello? There we are. Try and draw some attention. Come on, dudes. There's supposed to be an AR-33 guard here somewhere. You piece of shit. Now he shows up. Okay. Well, screw you then. And nobody here. Whoa. There's a guard. There's a dead guard. This game is really, really good for me because the guards can't see over rails for some reason. Because, you know, this game's old. It was programmed differently. But basically being able to hide in plain sight is an incredible boon. Now the bitch of the level. These guards, or these scientists rather, just... They don't put their hands up. They just wander around pretty much aimlessly. And I don't know of any consistent way to get them to move. Guard? Where are you? I'll come back to that one in a minute. Because this guy's gonna be, drawn attention. I'm sorry, guys. My mind is just not here right now. Before I recorded this episode, I went out and walked about 4 or 5 miles playing Pokemon Go, and I'm fried. Get out of here, you shit! Okay, they're gone. Alright, so there's the inlet controls. And now up the spiral staircase. It's too bad I'm not playing this on Agent, because it is possible to just completely outrun Trevelyan and make it to the end of the level in, like, what, 2 minutes? Maybe even better than that, I don't know. It's been forever since I've done a speedrun of this game. Gotcha. And... gotcha. Sometimes you gotta get creative with these guards. Yeah, crack Yannis troops my ass. These guys are weak. And gotcha. I don't know how that guy didn't hit. Oh shoot! Alrighty, whew! Yeah, and remember how I said this level is generous with ammunition at the beginning? Well, it's generous with it here, too. Because there is an absolutely massive weapons cache right here. I don't know if it's existent in 00 Agent, but it's definitely here in Secret Agent. And I think that is everything. But unfortunately, it's all 9mm ammunition, so not very useful for the AR-33. Okay. I was worried that was going to attract the attention of the guards in the top walkway, but I think I'm in the clear. Alright, doubling back. Because I don't want to get ambushed. That's why I'm taking the time to kill just about every guard here. That didn't get any attention from anyone, did it? Okay. Well, I hit both of them, didn't kill both of them. Fuck, did you survive? And... gotcha. Right in the base of the skull. Alright, there's code card number one. Did I lure both guards out here? Yes. Okay, that's best case scenario. Do I want to go through there now? Yeah, I may as well. Because the other way is the best way to go to get to the end. My problem here is... I don't know if killing those two scientists back there will cost me the mission, and it looks like it didn't. And I didn't see the radio come up as damaged either. Holy shit, I wish I were playing this on 00 Agent, because I would have lucked out. All those guards killed themselves and left the radio untouched. Let's get the other secret that's right in there. Because it gets smaller and smaller, like those Russian dolls. Until, oh, look at that, two computer monitors pop out. And inside them, twin AR-33s. God, I love this level. And doubling back once again. And Yeah, that didn't attract as much attention as I wanted it to. Where'd you go? Piece of shit. Alright, so these guards down here somehow do not see me. And how do I do this so... I'm thinking this one? One of them saw me. Alright, I think we're in the clear now. That should be all the code cards, so let's get the hell out of here. Close that behind me, because holy fuck. Blow up, damn you! There was no explosion. I've got guards behind me, guards everywhere. Okay. Well, that's it for caverns. And here we are at the end. N42, that's not too bad, actually. Here we are, Antenna Cradle. Destroy console, settle score with Trevelyan. The Ennis control communications have been jammed and the GoldenEye satellite orbit is decaying. Only Trevelyan and his personal bodyguard remain unaccounted for. You know my feelings about personal vendettas interfering with mission success, 007. However, in this case, I think we can turn a blind eye to whatever happens out there. Be careful, and remember, you are licensed to kill. Would you believe it, 007? There's another blasted control thingy actually on the antenna cradle. Trevelyan might be able to realign the antenna and get one last firing message through to the GoldenEye satellite. Get out there and destroy it. We don't want things going pear-shaped at the last minute. The hand that rocks the cradle rules the world, James. You know I won't sleep soundly until you get back to England in one piece. Alright. Time to finish off this bad boy. It's just you and me now, Trevelyan. Seriously, that's two! Oh, and my controller's jamming up. You could have joined me, but you had to side with the pin pushers. I need to slow up just a little bit here. Always loyal to the mission, never to your friends. Which way'd he go? James Bond, Her Majesty's loyal carrier. Defender of the so-called faith. What's the matter, James? No glib remark? No pithy comeback? Why won't he run? Ah, I need to go this way. I need more ammo. Come on, this has got to be the last one. Come on, is that the best you can do? Please have gone upwards. Damn it! Oh, he did. Nice fake out. Oh, you whore! You never do give up, do you? Pathetic, really? No, because I'm John fucking Cena. Never give up, never surrender. Alright, I need to stop making jokes and focus here, because I'm about to get screwed. You'll never win, James. Finish the job, James, if you can. Alright, here we are. It's go time. Millions guards aren't fucking around, and neither am I. For England, James? No. And there it is, ladies and germs, we did it. We defeated 006 and saved the world once again. All right, well, that is it for Let's Play GoldenEye 007. However, if you will, stay tuned for a bonus episode which will feature Aztec and Egyptian. And as always, if you've liked the video, be sure to like, comment, and or subscribe. Also, click those links down in the description, follow me on Facebook and Twitter, and if you will, head on over to my Patreon and support this channel by donating a couple of bucks per month. That's really all I've got to say for now. We win. So, until next time, this is Lance Cassidy, signing off.